In this video, I'm going to be talking about lymphedema, specifically about the lymphatic system and why lymphedema occurs. I'm Dr. Alex Hill, your physical therapist for everything oncology and pelvic health. Let's get into it. Let's first take a look at the big picture, which is the entire lymphatic system. This is a huge network of organs, lymph nodes, and lymph vessels that make and move lymph fluid from the tissues to the bloodstream. Think of it like a big highway system running all throughout the body with toll booths and boundaries, and then the lymph fluid is the cars on the highway. The lymphatic system is a major part of the body's immune system. Most people are familiar with one of the parts, which are lymph nodes. You know, those little bean-shaped organs that get swollen and tender if you get sick? Yep, those are part of the lymphatic system. When there's damage to the lymphatic system, whether that be the lymph nodes or the lymph vessels, or if it doesn't develop properly, lymphedema can occur. If we think about it like the highway analogy, imagine an accident on the highway that causes a backup of traffic, or if the roadways aren't able to accommodate a lot of people driving. That backup of traffic is going to be the backup of fluid, which is called lymphedema. Let's break down the word lymphedema. Edema means swelling, so lymphedema means swelling caused by an abnormal accumulation of lymph fluid. There's two types of lymphedema, primary and secondary. Primary lymphedema occurs when the lymphatic system doesn't develop properly because of gene mutations. This means people are born with a lymphatic system that isn't working like it should. Primary lymphedema is rare and affects about 1 in 100,000 people in the US. It can be seen in infants, among people going through puberty or during pregnancy, usually up until age 35, or there are some people older than 35 who can develop lymphedema as well in the primary setting. Secondary lymphedema occurs when there's damage to the lymphatic system. This can include surgery, especially a surgery that removes lymph nodes, which is pretty common for people who are cancer survivors, radiation therapy, which is a common treatment for cancer, skin infection like cellulitis, trauma or injury, or even things like venous diseases and obesity. These are all things that can damage the lymphatic system and cause secondary lymphedema or that backup of fluid. Something important to understand about lymphedema is that, unfortunately, it's not a curable condition. Treatment involves daily management to keep the swelling under control. Additionally, lymphedema is a progressive condition. This means that if it's not diagnosed and treated early, it can progress and get worse. There are four stages of lymphedema. They are stage zero, or latency stage. This is called subclinical, and this is where the swelling is not evident, even though the lymph transportation is impaired. This stage can exist for months or even years before edema becomes evident. Stage one is an accumulation of fluid that decreases with limb elevation. So if you have swelling in your legs that gets worse throughout the day, but then it completely goes away when you prop your feet up at the end of the day or in the morning when you wake up, this may indicate stage one lymphedema. Pitting is common, which is where you have deep indentations on the skin if you press on it. Stage two is characterized by swelling that does not go away when you elevate your legs or arms. Pitting may be present, and fibrosis, or thickening of the tissue, often starts in this stage. Stage three is lymphostatic elephantiasis. This stage, the swelling does not go away with elevation, and there are skin changes, including warty growths and skin color changes, usually a darkening of the skin in that affected area. Like I mentioned before, early treatment is key to having the best outcomes with lymphedema, but don't worry, even if you have severe stage three lymphedema, treatment is still available and it will help. Find a certified lymphedema therapist near you to get started on treatment right away. I'm putting several links in the description below to help you find a certified lymphedema therapist near you. Make sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notifications so that you don't miss any new videos on lymphedema or lymphedema management.